हरे कृष्ण प्रश्नाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामी नामिने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रश्नाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्य देशतारिणे ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्रीगुरुवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देगं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पदे गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त नमोऽस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वरा परम कृष्णा सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिरादिर्गोविंदा सर्वकारण कारणम्। हरे कृष्ण। बाय द कॉसलेस मर्सी ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड एट श्री कृष्णा वी आर नाइसली स्टडिंग भगवद्गीता एवरी डे एंड नाउ वी फिनिश 16 श्लोकास इन द 12th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद्गीता। So that is Bhakti Yoga, devotional service. In this chapter, Krishna is now teaching us what are the qualities if we have, we are dearer to Krishna. We will become dear to Krishna. So our goal should be achieving, getting all these qualities in this life so that we will be able to please Krishna. So all the time, we are talking about pleasing Krishna with our activities. That means doing everything up to Krishna's expectations. In this material world, whatever we do, always we are trying to please someone. At work, trying to please the boss, or at home, trying to please the family members, or wherever we go with friends, we are trying to please the friends. So everywhere we are trying to please others only. Why we think that by doing so, we are pleased. So we are able to live a happy life. So that's why we are trying to please others. Now, we need to understand from this Bhagavad Gita that by pleasing Krishna, so by doing everything up to Krishna's expectations, everyone will be pleased. So Krishna is teaching in Bhagavad Gita very clearly about how to please him. How to do everything for Krishna. The first important step is studying and understanding this full Bhagavad Gita knowledge, getting this knowledge. That's what is very important. Tadviddhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya. So upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshinam. So this jnana, this knowledge is very, very important. Jnana nirduta kalmasha. So jnana nirduta kalmasha means with this knowledge, all our misgivings, all our ignorance will be dispelled completely with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So we know exactly what to do, how to do, and everything will become, our path will become very clear with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So then by Krishna's mercy, we will be able to follow his instructions and please Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. We will be able to please him with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. That's what we are trying to do. We are studying this knowledge, getting this knowledge and understanding. And now Krishna is teaching us how to lead a life, how to do our activities every day. Because we understand even the scientific knowledge about our body also. Even the doctors, they go to medical school, they study only about the body, but they don't even study about the mind, senses and intelligence and how these things are all related, connected. Of course, they study about the senses, means how the neurons work in our body, how the sensory organs, they work, how we will receive the sensory inputs, the signals, and then how it is getting transmitted into our brain, and like the sensory network systems, like afferent neurons, and then how the motor neurons work. So to we understand scientifically how all these things are working, but how they interact with the mind and how the soul is actually suffering or enjoying by our actions. So karya karana kartrutve hetu prakriti ruchyate purushaga sukha dukkana bhoktrutve hetu ruchyate. So such kind of knowledge is not taught anywhere. We are not responsible for any of our actions, and everything is carried out by the modes of nature. Prakriti jair gunai purushaga prakriti stohi bhunte prakriti jan gunan. So prakriti jan gunan. So swabhava prabhavai prakriti. So swabhava prabhavai. So our swabhava. So our swabhava is produced from prabhavai gunai. So our swabhava is produced from the gunas, the three modes of material nature. So no college, no medical school, nowhere they teach about the three modes of material nature, the mode of goodness, passion and ignorance, and how they control us. So that way, so Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is teaching us very, very scientifically, very clearly how we are acting, how we are forced to act, why we are actually forced to act, and how to get ourselves free from that force, that bondage. So that knowledge we are getting only in Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is teaching us very clearly so that we won't get another body. That's what is very important. Otherwise, we will be, after death, we will be forced into another body. This maya, the three modes of material nature, the gunas, sattva, rajas, tama, iti, gunaga, prakriti, sambhavaga, nibandhanandi mahabhago, dege, devginam, avyayam. So it keeps on binding the soul inside this body. So dege, devginam, avyayam. So we need to put a stop to this. Stop to this nonsense. So that is going to be possible only when we act as per Krishna's instructions in Bhagavad Gita. So we are getting this knowledge. We are understanding everything about ourselves. We know that we are the we are the soul, we are not the body. And Krishna is the super soul. And Krishna is teaching us about how to fix our mind on Krishna. How to focus. Krishna is giving. You sit straight, don't look at any other directions. So just think about me and control your mind. Manasamyamya machitto. So just you control your mind by focusing your mind on me. So that is the only way we can control our mind. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna has said many, many, many times that you focus your mind on me, fix your mind on me. This Krishna has said almost many slokas, Krishna says. So because that is the only way we can actually control our mind. If you focus on anything else, our mind will be out of our control. If our mind, if you think about anything else other than Krishna, immediately it gets out of our control. We cannot control. We cannot keep our mind under our control. In that case, it won't be our friend. It won't be friend to us. It will become our enemy. It will become our worst enemy. If our mind is not under our control, then our mind will become our worst enemy. So that means it's going to bring us a lot of sufferings, a lot of miseries. The mind will go everywhere and invite miseries and bring troubles to us. If we are not able to fix our mind on Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. As long as our mind is connected with Krishna, not thinking about anything else, so we are very safe, we are very happy. Our mind is very peaceful. As soon as we forget Krishna, then we are in trouble. As long as we remember Krishna, we are safe. As soon as we forget Krishna, we are in trouble. That's what we need to understand. So that means we should all the time remember Krishna. That's why Krishna is teaching, sarvesu kalesu, all the time you remember me. Ananyas chintayantoma, without any deviation you think about me. Ananya chetaga satatam yomam smarati nityasaka, without any deviation you always remember me. So that's what Krishna is teaching us repeatedly in Bhagavad Gita, that we need to focus our mind on Krishna all the time. Machittaga, machittaga, sarvadurgani, matprasada tarishyasi. If you fix your mind upon me, by my mercy, all your miseries, all your troubles will be gone. So, the whole purpose of Bhagavad Gita is to control our mind and keep the mind as our best friend just by following the procedure given by Krishna, the instructions given by Krishna. Then our mind is going to be our best friend, actually, our best friend all the time. Banduratma. It will be our bandhu. Banduratma. One should use the mind to elevate oneself, not to downgrade himself. Uddareta atman atmanam, natmanam avasadi. So, atmaivage atmano bandur, atmaiva ripura atmana. So, the mind is friend as well as enemy. So, we need to train our mind to be our friend. We should not let our mind to be our enemy and destroy us. Banduratma atmanastasya yena atmaiva atmana jitaga anatmanastu satrutve varteta atmaiva satruvat. So for one who has conquered the mind is the best of friends. But for one who has failed to do so, the mind will remain the worst enemy. So we should not keep our mind as our worst enemy. We should keep our mind as our best friend. We should train our mind. Jitatmanaga prashantasya paramatma samahitaga sitoshna sukadukkesu tatha mana apamana. So if we are able to conquer our mind, if we control our mind, so then we will be able to reach Krishna. We will be able to experience, feel the paramatma, the super soul who is seated in our heart. So at that point of time, we will be able to become ourselves free from all dualities in this material world. Sitoshna sukadukka tatha mana apamana. So free from winter and summer seasons, happiness and distress, and honor and dishonor. So all the dualities in this material world. We will not be affected by anything in this material world. Because our mind is not thinking about anything in this material world. Our mind is always thinking only about Krishna. So that's the way we need to train our mind. So at that point of time, for us, everyone should be same. Everyone. Surun mudrari, so everyone, udasina madhyastha dvesha bandushu sadhuswapicha papeshu samabuddhi vishishyate. So well-wishers, friends, enemies, surun mitrari, udasina, neutrals, madhyastha, mediators, sadhuswapicha papeshu, everyone, madhyastha dvesha bandushu, enemies and relatives and sadhus, saints and papes, even the sinners, everyone samabuddhir vishishyate. Everyone we will be able to see them equally. So that is the way we can free ourselves from the three modes of material nature. So when Arjuna asks the question in the 14th chapter, what are the symptoms by which I can understand one is freed from the modes of material nature? Krishna is listing down the qualities. It's very important. Krishna is teaching us the tulya priya, priyo, dhiraga, tulya nindatma, samstuti, tulya, 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 like that Krishna is using the word tulya. Tulya means equal. So one who is not disturbed by anything, who is equal to everything. So that is the way we need to train our mind with the help of this Bhagavad Gita knowledge. This Bhagavad Gita knowledge only is going to help us to tune our mind, to remember Krishna all the time. So this subject, this science is not taught anywhere. No one can teach. Only Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the source of everything, only He can give this knowledge to us, and He has given this knowledge to us in this Bhagavad Gita. So now, it is very important for us to study and understand, irrespective of where we are, what, irrespective of caste, creed, religion, everything. This Bhagavad Gita belongs to the soul. It belongs to the Atma. That's what is very important. It is the science about ourself. So without knowing about ourself, without knowing about our soul, ourself, so knowing about everything else is, what is the use? How is it going to be useful? If you know everything about our body, how it works, how is it going to be useful? If we get some disease, we can protect ourselves. But can we protect ourselves from the death? No way. Can the modern science, all this technology, what we have, can it stop ourselves dying? It is not at all possible. This birth, old age, disease and death is being forced upon us. So if you want to stop dying, if you want to stop death, we should not take birth. That is the only way we can stop death. So that immortality, so we can achieve only if we don't take birth again. So now we are going to die. There is no doubt we are going to die. But we can make decision now. We can act now. This is the time to act. This is the time to get this knowledge and use this knowledge and then achieve a life where there is no death. So we can stop. Otherwise, this is keep on going to happen. Wherever, whichever planet we go, we can design satellites, spaceships, everything we can do, and we can go to other planets. Wherever we go, we cannot stop the death. So that's what we need to know. Because this body is a machine. That's what we need to know. Any machine we create, are there any machine which is permanently working? No. It will, over a period of time, it will fail. So everything has got its own life. This earth itself is going to fail. This earth itself is going to be completely destroyed. That's what we need to understand. So then what's the point of thinking ourselves that we can live here for enough forever? There is no way it is possible. So, but it is possible for us to stop birth. That is the very important thing. We can stop taking birth in this world again. So we need to focus on death. We are going to die. There is no doubt. But we can stop ourselves taking birth again in this world. So that opportunity is there for us. So that is going to be possible only with this Bhagavad Gita knowledge. So this is a science. Otherwise, if we think that everything else is fine, all these science advancements, scientific advancements, this technology, all those things are great. So like that, if you all think, if we forget to realize that we are not the body, we are the soul, then we are very, very unfortunate. What to say? It's very unfortunate. We have taken already countless number of births, innumerable number of births. We have died so many times. So we don't want this nonsense to repeat again. So that way, this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is going to help us. Only this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is going to help us to control our mind and make our mind as our best friend. And we can lead a happy life in this life itself. We can achieve permanent happiness in this life itself. We don't have to think or worry about anything in this life. We simply can lead a very happy and blissful life now, just by focusing our mind on Krishna. That doesn't mean that we will not have any knowledge, or we will be like fools, or we will not be after material sense objects. Not like that. Material sense objects, of course, we are not after them, but they are after us. That's what is going to happen. If we are going after Krishna, if we are just focusing our mind on Krishna, so whatever the material needs, actually, they are going to come to us. They will be after us. Here, otherwise, in this material world, we are working so hard to earn our daily bread. We are getting so much stress. We are wasting our life, the precious human life. But if we just understand this Bhagavad Gita and take shelter unto Krishna, so then Krishna is going to supply what all we need. That Krishna will definitely do that. No devotee will become a beggar and lead a very life without any material things, actually. So Krishna will take care. But the devotee will not go after material things. That's what is very important. So the devotee will go only after Krishna. So for him, only Krishna is everything. So that way, we will be able to lead a very happy life, focusing only on Krishna, not worrying about anything in this material world. Whatever is happening, nothing should bother us. Nothing should affect us. So, yadate moha kalilam buddhir vyatittarishyadi tada gantasi nirvedam shrotavyasya sutasya. So, when our intelligence has passed through the dense forest of illusion, yadate moha kalilam buddhir vyatittarishyadi tada gantasi nirvedam shrotavyasya sutasya. So we won't be affected by whatever we have heard and whatever we are going to hear. Nothing is going to bother us. Nothing is going to affect us. So our goal is only to focus on Krishna, to think about Krishna, to serve Krishna, to please Krishna, always in Krishna consciousness, to live for Krishna, to eat for Krishna, to sleep for Krishna, do everything for Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So that way our life will be full of Krishna consciousness. And that way, by Krishna's causeless mercy, we won't be disturbed by anything in this material world. We know that only the three modes of material nature are acting. So we know that very well. So that way, we should only depend on Krishna completely. So then by Krishna's mercy, we can actually free ourselves from these three modes of material nature. That is the only way. So that is the only way to control our mind, by focusing our mind on Krishna. That is the only way to free ourselves from the three modes of material nature, by surrendering unto Krishna out of love and devotion. So then only we can actually, we can get the liberation from this material modes of nature. Then only we can achieve peace of mind, control our mind, and make our mind as our best friend. Simply, there is no other way at all. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, in the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, we finished 16 shlokas. So Krishna is teaching us that what are all the qualities which make us to become dearer to Krishna. So in the shloka what we studied yesterday, Krishna taught us that anapekshaga suchir daksha udasino gatavyataka sarvarambha parityagi yomad bhaktaga same priyaga. That's what we studied. So one who is not envious, anapekshaga suchir daksha, so who is a daksha, so who is an expert, and who is pure, suchir daksha, and udasino, who is neutral, and gatavyataga, so who is freed from all the distress himself, so gatavyataga, then sarvarambha parityagi, who is able to renounce everything in all endeavors, renounce everything, no attachment to the results, so yo madbhaktaga same priya, is my devotees and very dear to me. That's what Krishna is teaching. So now in the next shloka, what we are studying in the shloka number 17, Krishna is teaching there. Yo na krishyati na dveshti na sochati na kankshati shubha shubha parityagi bhaktiman yasame priyaga. That's what Krishna is teaching us. Yo na krishyati na dveshti. That means one who doesn't take pleasure, or who doesn't envy, who doesn't grieve. So yo na krishyati na dveshti. So we have studied many times. Krishna has already taught us. So Krishna in the many shlokas, Krishna is like dukkesu anudvignam anaga sukesu vigatas prigaga. So that's what we studied in the second chapter. So in the shloka number 56, Krishna taught us that when there is distress, one should not be disturbed in mind. When there is dukkesu anudvignam anaga sukesu vigatas prigaga. So when there is happiness, one should not be elated too much. So that's like that. Here Krishna is saying that one should not be taking pleasure too much on material things, or one should not be grieving too much, all such things. So na pragrishet priyam prapya no dvijet prapya cha priyam. That's what in the fifth chapter we studied. So when we achieve what we want, na pragrishet. So don't jump around too much. Na pragrishet priyam prapya no dvijet prapya cha priyam. So when we get what we don't want, also one should not be agitated too much. So that's what na pragrishet priyam prapya no dvijet apriyam. So then in the ninth chapter also we studied, Krishna said that subha shubha parityagi. So subha shubha palaireva mokshase karma bandhanaga. So sannyasi yoga yuktoma vimuktoma mupaisasi. So that's what subha shubha palaireva. So one who is free from the auspicious and inauspicious things. So same thing here Krishna is teaching us, that yo nagarshyati na dveshti na sochati na kankshati. So one who neither laments nor desires. That's what nasochati na kankshati. In the 18th chapter, Krishna is going to teach us that Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma nasochati na kankshati madbhaktim labate pala. So Krishna is saying that Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma nasochati na kankshati samaga sarvesu bhutesu madbhaktim labate pala. So a person who has achieved that Brahman platform, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, the happiest person, he neither laments nor desires for anything. So na sochati na kankshati. So that's what here Krishna is saying, that na sochati na kankshati subha subha parityagi. Subha and asubha, both auspicious and inauspicious results. So who is not affected, subha subha parityagi bhaktiman yas same priya. So he is the devotee, bhaktiman, so yas same priya. So he is such a devotee, is dear to me. So such a devotee is very dear to me. That's what Krishna is teaching. So one who neither rejoices nor grieves, who neither laments nor desires, who renounces both auspicious and inauspicious things, such a devotee is very dear to me. That's what Krishna is teaching. So we will become very, very dearer to Krishna because we are studying this Bhagavad Gita. We are getting this knowledge. We have full faith on Krishna. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, definitely we will become dearer to Krishna. There is no doubt. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have very successfully finished this sloka number 17 in the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So we just have to finish 3 more slokas to finish this 12th chapter. Hare Krishna. I'll stop now and we'll discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you, Guruji.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna to all the devotees. I request you to post the questions in the chat window so that Thimur Prabhu can coordinate the questions to Guruji right now. Hare Krishna. You can also